With all the concerns surrounding mosquito bites and Zika, we spoke to an expert to get the facts and information on reducing the spread of the virus.
Dr. Aileen Marty is professor of infectious diseases in the Department of Medicine at Florida International University. She says aside from the confirmed cases of Zika in Wynwood, there are a lot more people who have been infected in the area and don't even know it. According to the Florida Department of Health, 80% of those infected with Zika have no symptoms. Dr. Marty says those individuals are mostly at risk to the community rather than to themselves.
That person becomes particularly important if that individual is the partner of a woman who either wants to get pregnant or is pregnant. That individual should get tested, even though that person has not had symptoms.
According to the Centers for Disease Control, those who do show symptoms have fever, rash, joint pain, or red eyes, which can last up to a week. Researchers say only those who have been in an area where there is known active mosquito transmission should get tested. In our conversation with Dr. Marty, I asked, how long does the Zika virus stay in the body?
In men, we now know that there is active virus almost 100 days after they initially present with symptoms, and that may be pushed even further. In pregnant women, we've seen it for over a month in the pregnant woman, active virus. So we're not sure because this is an evolving issue, and we keep learning more and more as we study this virus intently now.
The professor says the recommendations for a man who's had Zika or known exposure to Zika should wait 6 months before having unprotected sex. She says even though a man may be in the clear after 6 months, any male who has had Zika should not have unprotected sex with a pregnant woman throughout the pregnancy.
Because there are many infectious diseases, and Zika is one of them, where if you develop certain types of problems, you can have long-lasting effects. So that small percentage of people that develop autoimmune reaction to the virus, which is typically seen as a Guillain-Barré paralysis that they can recover from, although very few people have actually died from Guillain-Barré, if you recover from it, you may have long-term consequences.
The main risk of the Zika virus is that it can cause severe brain defects to the fetus, including microcephaly, which causes problems with hearing, vision, and growth, including an abnormally small head. But Dr. Marty says those birth defects are not automatic.
And this risk is highest in the first trimester when the brain is developing at a very, very fast rate. It becomes less and less towards the end of the pregnancy. But it's not zero, even at the end of pregnancy.
Bottom line, every single person who goes anywhere near where there may be mosquitoes that have Zika should be using personal protection like insect repellent. There are a number of EPA-approved ingredients that are very effective against mosquitoes that transmit Zika. Researchers recommend DEET repellent that's 30% or less.
Now here, what you have is one of the brands of Permethrin. Permethrin is a product that is applied to gear and to clothing. It only works on gear and clothing. It doesn't work on your skin. And it's on my clothing. All my clothing that I have on right now is filled with permethrin. That's a strong, strong repellent for mosquitoes, for ticks. It's great against Lyme disease. It's great against all kinds of arthropods.
It's important to note that too much of anything can be harmful. So when applying repellent, put these products on as the manufacturer's labels direct for use.
And there's another thing that you have to bear in mind, and that is that by not getting bitten, you are reducing the mosquito population. So everybody who prevents mosquitoes from biting them is keeping a female from getting that blood meal that she needs to lay eggs. So personal protection helps you, personal protection helps your community and decreases the risk of harm to a pregnant woman who may live nearby, and it also helps our livelihood.